thing is really to make sure you know how to score your mark for biostats. Question come out, you should celebrate, because very easy, you should score full marks, okay? So unless you're careless, otherwise full marks is definitely there, okay, right? Application, you must understand main thing for biostats is for you to determine whether differences are real or not. That means whether differences are due to chance or sampling error or not. Okay? One thing I want to emphasize is when you do biostats, definitely there is differences. Okay, so you don't expect a case whereby there are no differences. Definitely will have differences, but your purpose is to determine whether the difference is significant or not. Two tests in your syllabus, chi-square and t-test. Chi-square test, purpose, test the significance of difference. That means, if I look at two sets of data, the two sets of data are different, but my question here is whether the difference is significant or not. More importantly, you will use chi-square test when you see discrete categories, meaning discontinuous variation. Okay, so chi-square test is for discontinuous variation, like gender, male or female. Okay, like for example, color, whether it's red flower or blue flower. Okay, so very only for discrete categories. Okay, next thing, formula for chi-square test is as such. I think your max is pretty good, right? So I don't need to explain what is the summation sign. Okay, ma? Now, I want you to make changes to your lecture notes now. Now, because of the printing, the summation sign inside your lecture notes seems to be summation for 上面那个, which is bracket O minus E squared. No, the summation is for the whole thing. So can you remove the summation sign in your lecture notes and put it at the correct place? Summation is for O minus E squared over E. Okay, you summation, you do a summation for that. So change the position of your summation sign, please. Change now in case you confuse yourself. Okay, in this case, O is the observed value and E is the expected value. V stands for degree of freedom and C is the number of classes. I want you to make some annotation because some of you might be confused. What is number of classes? So in your own lecture notes, put down there number of phenotypic class. Maybe that will make it easier for you. Okay, test you monohybrid inheritance. Okay, in order to do stats, your genetics must be strong. Okay, monohybrid inheritance, heterozygote cross with heterozygote, degree of freedom is? No, three. Monohybrid. Monohybrid means what? Only one gene, one characteristic. Heterozygote cross with heterozygote means, for example, big T small t cross with big T small t. What is the degree of freedom? How come it's one? Because you only have how many phenotypic class? It's either tall or short. Degree of freedom is 2 minus 1. Okay, ma? Let's say we are looking at two discrete categories. For biostats, usually looking at two between your data, that means the actual experiment, and your expected. So if it's two, it's like that. So you understand how the summation sign works, right? So initially it's like that, the summation. So now you calculate the O minus E over E for one set, then you add to the one for the second set of data. So that's the idea of the summation sign. Do I need to elaborate further on how to do this? Can you understand? Okay, great. Okay, now, under what kind of circumstances will I be using a chi-square test? We go back to this. Under what kind of circumstances will we be using a chi-square test? For example, in theory, let's say I give you a $1 coin. In theory, when you toss a coin, what is the probability of getting a tail? You don't know what a coin is. Tail is like Singapore $1 coin. I toss it 10 times. In theory, how many times will be your tail? 5 times. Hey, 5 times. That is your expected. So now I take out a coin and I toss. I don't you imagine. Okay, toss, toss, toss. Okay. I only have 3 tails and 7 heads. Is my data different from the expected? Is this significant? You don't know. Maybe the difference is because I just very sway. If I very sway, the difference is due to chance. Then it's not significant. Swayness is not significant. But maybe the difference is because that coin is one side heavy and one side light. So is this due to chance? So is this difference then significant? Yes. That's the whole idea. You want to check whether the difference is significant or not. Okay, we'll go to page 3 of your lecture notes. We'll do some exercise. Page 3. Because this biostats is part of genetic basis of variation. So this is tested during exam. Okay, mid-year. Okay, page 3 will bring you to this, right? Okay, let's go through the case study together. Okay, like I say, your genetics needs to be strong. Over here, what we see? True breeding parents of contrasting phenotype. Okay, ma? True breeding straight cross with true breeding curve. This is true. This is pure breeding parents of contrasting phenotypes. So the F1 must be your heterozygote. How do you know F1 is heterozygote? Because you're crossing pure breeding parents of contrasting phenotypes. Okay? Now next. F1 are allowed to mate with each other. So this is actually your selfing of interbreeding of H1. Interbreeding of H1. So this is a H times H. Heterozygote times heterozygote. Okay? This is how many genes, how many characteristics? One gene, one characteristic. Expected outcome? Expected outcome? 3 is to 1, 1 is to 1. This is heterozygote times heterozygote. 3 is to 1, okay? Expected is 3 is to 1. Do your paper. Now, you must always state two hypotheses when you do your chi-square. The first hypothesis is called H0. The second hypothesis is called HA. HA stands for the alternative hypothesis. Do you understand? Oh, wonderful. They go very fast. Okay, right? So H0, one way I remember is H0 got a zero there, then the definition also got a zero. It means no diff. Okay? There is no sit diff. Between observe, what is the observe? Is 262 and 90. Do you know where I get this data from? From the experiment, right? 262 and 90. Okay? And the expected is 3 is to 1. So H0 is no significantly. Alternative hypothesis HA is the significant. And then this is max, right? You know how to count? So how do you calculate? How do I get 264 and 88? Observe, I copy from the data, right? I copy 262 and 90. But how do I get 264 and 88? Add together, divide by 4, then times 3 and times 1, because the expected ratio is 3 is to 1. Okay? So after that, what do? I calculate O minus E, and then I calculate O minus E. Yeah, you can calculate that, okay? I don't know how to pronounce this formula, okay? So after that, you will need to do your summation for the two sets of data, right? The first set of data is 0.0152. That is the O minus E squared over E for the first set of data. The second set of data, the O minus E squared over E is for this. So you should get your chi-square value should be 0.607. Once again, I think I really have to apologize for the printing error. Can you please make your paper away this day? The E should be for the whole formula, not the on top. Okay, so can you just shift the summation sign? It should be for the whole formula. It's not just the top portion. Okay, what is the degree of freedom? Once again, can you change? Can you put an annotation in your lecture notes? Degree of freedom here is phenotypic class. Okay, minus 1. In this case, the degree of freedom is 1. Now, how do I know the degree of freedom is 1? Let's go back. When you do your interbreeding of F1, look at the phenotype. How many phenotypic class are there? 2. The first class is straight wing. The second one is curve. So the degree of freedom is 2 phenotypic class minus 1 equals to 1. So once I get my degree of freedom, my chi-square value is 0.607. My degree of freedom is 1. I must then use a chi-square table. Okay? Now, there are 2 methods. Can you listen? There are 2 methods of using the chi-square table. You need to be familiar with both methods because sometimes the examiner will dictate which method you use. So you must be familiar with both. The first method is you look at the p-value. Okay? If you look at the p-value and then you determine. The second method is you look at the critical value. Okay, so go to the table. Let me show you the table. You still remember what was the chi-square value? I can't remember, can you help me? What was the chi-square value? Okay, so now we know that, or you must memorize that the cutoff is here, where the red line is. The cutoff is p equal 0.05. The value is, the probability is if the probability is greater or equals to 0.05, you do not reject H0. If otherwise, you reject. So first method is you look at the chi-square value. Chi-square value falls between the blue region. Right? Just now we calculate already. It falls between the blue region. So after that, I look at for this blue circle, what is the corresponding probability? The corresponding probability is between 0.95 and 0.8. And the first method is I see that this is greater than 0.05, so I do not reject H0. That's the first method. What is the second method? The second method is use the critical value. Where is the critical value? For the degree of freedom 1, the critical value is the one that corresponds to 0.05. So the critical value is 3.841. So it is greater or equal to the critical value, I do not reject. So again, there are 2 ways to do it. Number 1, compare the green region. Whether it's greater or equal to, if it's greater or equal to 0.05, do not reject. Number 2, compare the blue region. Greater or equal to 3.841, you do not reject. So the green one is comparing P value. The blue one is comparing critical value. Okay, ma? Okay, green region is p-value, which is the probability. The blue one is your critical value. Okay, we will take 1 minute for you to discuss with your friend. Can you just clarify with the one sitting beside you? Make sure the person knows how to prepare. Equals to 1. Okay? Now go to the high-stress fever. So, let's look at this. Now, why I look at number one? Because the degree of freedom is one. Why I look at this blue region? Because my chi-square value 0.060 something like that, falls here. Falls between this region. Okay, ma? So these two blue things is I get after I press my calculator. Okay, now I need to determine whether or not to reject H dot, right? So what I do? I will look at this blue one and find the corresponding p value. So the blue one, the corresponding p value is this, between 0.95 and 0.8. Okay? So now, is this p value, now this 0.05 is predetermined, it's always 0.05. Okay, one change one, you must always remember, it's always that one. So is this p value greater or equals to 0.05? Yes, so you do not reject. That's the first method. Oh, let me tell you the second method. This is the first method. Okay, go back. Second method. Okay. Second method is, okay, I press my calculator, I have this value in blue. Right? I have degree of freedom equals to 1. The chi-square value is 0.0607, which is between here. Then how do I do the second method is, I look at, don't look at the green thing, I look at the chi-square value for 0.05. The critical value for 0.05. The second method is I always look at the critical value for 0.05, which is 3.841. I just ask myself, is this greater or equals to the critical value? If yes, do not reject. Just look at the blue one only, the second method. The first method, look at the green one. The second method, just look at the blue one. Okay, so it's two methods. Okay? How? Go through the answer in the lecture exercise with you. Now highlight this. Tapien, after step 5, under method 1, there's a conclusion, right? You want to be at the correct page. Can you tell your friend what page is it? What page? Page 5. You highlight this in a special color and put them memorized. You need to memorize the format, that is how to phrase your sentences. Okay, whenever you are given a chi-square question, this is the standard phrasing for your answer. Given that the chi-square value is blah and V equals to blah, the probability, okay, then you move on to this. So you put that memorized, standard phrasing. You do need to highlight what are the areas to change, right? Should I highlight for you? Need or not? Okay, so this is something you need to change, right? Chi-square is whatever. The problem is between, this one also not sure. You need to figure out for yourself. I don't know whether it's greater or not, you need to figure out. Hence, whether you reject or not, you need to figure out. That is, you mean significant, you need to figure out. Whether it differs or not, you need to figure out. So expected ratio, 不是每次 3 to 1, depends on the questions. So the yellow one is the variable. That means the blanks in your statement. Okay? Done? Need more time? Okay. Who needs more time? Raise your hand. I'll pause. Raise your hand, we need time. Okay. Okay, example one. So, you are looking at pure breeding normally purple stem crossed with potato leaf green stem. So, this is pure breeding parent of contrasting phenotype. So it means your F1 will be a heterozygote. How do you know F1 is heterozygote? Because you are crossing pure breeding parent of contrasting phenotype. Okay? Then they say one of the offspring, which is a H, is crossed with potato leaf and green stem. Potato leaf and green stem is homozygous recessive. So this is a test cross. The description here is H cross with a homozygous recessive, so you are looking at a test cross. And they want you to carry a chi-square test to find out what? Find out whether the segregating allele are at 2 loci. What's the meaning of 2 loci? 2 loci means whether they are linked genes or not. If it's unlinked, heterozygote, with a test cross is no. It is unlinked. If it's linked, what is the expected, what is the ratio if it's linked? If linked, parental more than recombinant. Okay, so you write your H0 and HA. Okay? After that, check your answer. I think I don't need to go through the maths with you, you can press calculator. So this is the answer. Okay, please mark or write down. Good question there. Is it always a 3 decimal place? Actually, they don't mark for position here. Okay, they don't mark for position here, so it's up to you. Is there a calculation error?
Which one?
0.25. Uh-huh. Trust you. No need. The difference between O minus E can be negative as well. Yeah, you should put it as a negative, okay? If there's negative, please put in. Okay? Done? Got the answers? Can I move on? Okay. Degree of freedom equals to 3, yeah? Do you know how you get degree of freedom equals to 3? Because look here, how many phenotypic classes? 4. Degree of freedom is phenotypic classes minus 1. So 4 minus 1, degree of freedom is 3. So now you have 2 values already, right? Haven't. Okay, what is the chi-square value after you calculate? Do you know how to calculate chi-square value or not? Add all these together, right? It's the summation of this. So your chi-square value is 1.313. Degree of freedom is 3, so you must look at the third row. So after you look at the third row, search where is 1.313? It's in this circle. And then match up. What is the probability? It's between 0.8 and 0.50. So this is greater than 0.05. If it's greater than 0.05, you do not reject H0 in favor of HA. There's no safety. Okay, so I'll give you time to copy. Is this in your lecture notes? Okay. Do you need the yellow picture? No need, huh? Then it's just this. Please raise your hand if the register is with you, the class needs to be you. Now I can't collect. two, you're looking at this student who is very interested in periwinkles. So the student found 100 periwinkles on a rocky shore, and the student wrote the type of seaweed found on the periwinkles. Okay? So there are four possible types of seaweed that can be found in the periwinkle, and the student postulated that, okay, that is. Okay, this one now is a little bit tricky because you might not be able to pick up the expected. So you have to read the question carefully. Okay, let's focus. You have to read the question carefully for you to pick up the expected. Because of this word, the students say that the smooth periwinkle is more likely to be found. When the students say it's more likely to be found on bladder wrack than other seaweed, means, okay, the expected frequency is it is not more likely. So your expected will be equal probability. Okay, what I'm trying to say? Because the student claimed that it's more likely to be found, and you are trying to test whether there's a preference or not. So your expected is there's no preference. Means equally likely. So that's why it's 1-1-1-1 ratio. Okay, so this might be a little bit tricky for you to pick up. I need to read the description very carefully. Why it is 1-1-1-1 ratio. Okay? The answer you can note and mark. Can just note down the answer, but more importantly, note down why it's 1-1-1-1. Okay? Who needs more time at this screen? Raise your hand. Okay. Degree of freedom is 3. Why 3? Go back. How many fingertipping classes? 4. 4 minus 1 equals to 3. Chi-square value is 86.96. Mark your answer, 86.96. Okay, now I'm going to share with you how to use your GC to arrive at the chi-square without going through the tedious calculation. So this is how you use your GC. So what we're going to do is, you put your lecture notes to this page. Keep your lecture notes to this page. And I want you to key in all this data into your GC. Okay, so that's how you use your GC as follows. So go to stat, test, chi-square, goodness of fit. And then L1 is your data set 1, and L2 is 35. You should get your chi-square value. Okay, can you please try? Make sure you know how to use your GC. Chi-square GOF, don't choose the normal chi-square, you must choose the goodness of fit. There are two chi's in your calculator, choose the GOF one. Okay. So you realize that using the GC will save you a lot of time. You just have to key in data set 1, which is the data set for observed, and key in data set 2, which is the data set for expected. Then you don't need to do all this. I don't need to do all this already. The answer will magically bring you to 86.96. Then you just go to the p-value table. That's it. Okay? Now we move on to the next test, t-test. Okay, now. T-test is slightly different from chi-square test. T-test is, can we highlight the keyword? You are testing for difference in mean. You are not only testing for the data, that means the expected and observed difference, you are testing for the mean difference. So if you look at this graph, okay? The green one is the control group, the blue graph is the treatment group, but you are not comparing all the data points, you are comparing the black vertical line. You're comparing the mean of the green graph compared to the mean of the blue one. And you see whether there's any difference in the mean. Okay, not difference in the individual data set, it's difference in their mean. And t-test is only used for continuous variable. Chi-square is for discrete, that is discontinuous. So very easy to choose already, right? When to use chi-square and use t-test. Okay, next thing, t-test very stringent, more condition. The data set, that means the green graph and the blue graph must be related. And they must be normally distributed. That means if it's not normally distributed, you can't use t-test. Next thing, the data must have similar variance. Have you learned about standard deviation? The variance must be the same, It is not the same, then you need to use what you learn in math, right? Your two-tail t-test, right? So different, Okay, now over here, the sample size must be small, okay? So this is the formula for the bio, the bio's t-test. Do I need to explain standard deviation? You are very comfortable. Okay, so, can I move on? Okay, page 9 of your lecture notes. Okay, now state the null and alternative hypotheses, and you need to calculate the t value. Okay, highlight this please. Degree of freedom is different from your chi-square test. Degree of freedom here is n1 plus n2 minus 2. You know what is n, right? N is your sample size for group 1. The n2 is the sample size for group 2, okay? So sample size add together minus 2. So if the experiment has 70 sample and 80, so the degree of freedom is 70 plus 80 minus 2, okay? The sample size. And obviously, when you do your t-test, please don't try to use the chi-square table. That will be horrifying, okay? Use your t-test table. Okay, Kema, then I show you the table. It's the same principle. Cut-off value is probability equals to 0.05. Okay? Greater than or equals to, do not reject H0 and otherwise reject H0. Okay, so this is the same. The cutoff for biostats is always at p equals to 0.05. There are more stringent tests that have the p value 0.01. So please read the question carefully. Where is the p value? Unless otherwise stated, cutoff is 0.05. Okay, I'll go through the answer in the lecture notes with you first. So let's do example 1. So example 1, the answer, you only need to work out the last one, right? The number of fruit per plant, the one that's 48 and 55. So can you just check your answer? Check your answer. Okay, ma? Okay, I got one thing to highlight. This is a bad example. If during exam, they leave this big blank for you, you're supposed to, cannot just write 1.4, you're supposed to show the working, okay? The one during exam. Maybe now you also show the working, okay, in case you study the wrong thing. Please show your working, Show your own working now, write it down. Show working, please. The other one also minus 2.6, you must also show working, okay? So you write down your own working. Okay, let's move on. Is there any for me to go through how to calculate standard deviation? No, really, your learning is more important. A level you must be able to do. So, you know how to calculate standard deviation? No? Yes, all follow the formula, okay? So, you know the meaning of X bar, right? X bar means the mean, okay? So, you should get this value. Please check your answer if you didn't get this clarified. question, your T value is 1.767. Degree of freedom is, how do you get 10? You go back, so let me show you how to calculate degree of freedom. Degree of freedom is sample size. So look at this, spray with water. How many plants? 10. Spray with hand, 10. So sample size for first group is 10 plus, second group is 10 minus 2. Okay, so N1 plus N2 minus 2. So your degree of freedom is 18. So if the degree of freedom is 18, should I be looking at the first row or the second row? No, right? Neither. I should be looking at which row? The 18th row. So go to the 18th row, which is here. Search for 1.767. So search for 1.767, which is here. And this corresponds to what p-value? Look up. This corresponds to the p-value of between 0.05 and 0.025. Okay, so is it greater than or equals to 0.05? Yes. So is this value greater than or equals to 0.05? No. So should you or should not reject H0? Reject H0. In favor of HA. Okay?
Felicia is not here as well. 6B Felicia. Xiang Nan, you know why Felicia is not here?
She's very sick.
Okay, at this point in time, I'd like to emphasize that these last two bullet points here, you need to contextualize to whatever the question gives you, okay? So you must say there's significant difference in the, you just search the preamble and quote the relevant part. Okay, so it's not always about tomato, so read the question and quote. Your 1T equals 1.71. Okay. Okay, everyone, if you brought your calculator, please press. You need to get used to it. 2 sample T, yeah? Mu 1 not equals to mu 2, go to your data. Do you know where is the data set? Look at the data set for the hand-pollinated one. The other one is the... Okay, let me show you. Okay, data set is here. This is data set 1, the one that is sprayed with water. This is data set 2, the one that is hand-pollinated. Okay, so data set 1, please key in as L1, data set 2 as L2. Then after you key in, you should get the T equals to 1.767. Okay, I will switch back to the screen for this one, then you can look. Okay, please make sure you get 1.767.
Okay, ma. Please try, try out.
Okay, first thing is, we will always stick to mu 1 not equals to mu 2, we will always stick to no pooling of data, okay? We'll just stick to this standardization. The next thing is, don't worry if you get the negative sign, just look for the absolute value, okay? Just ignore the negative sign. And the third thing is, no need to memorize the formula, okay? Even the formula for standard deviation will be provided in the assessment paper. Okay, so there's no need to memorize any formula as well. Okay, last bit is I just need to do some advertising. We are done with lecture for today. So thank you for coming back for 2 days during the holiday. I want to advertise 2 workshops. So give me a while. Workshop. Okay, go to your bio, go to our bio website. Listen. Okay, here. Under Raffles Science Festival, you click. Okay, there are 2 workshops for you to sign for. Okay, a bit small, just you can read on your own. And listen. The first workshop is you must attend all 3 sessions. You cannot choose all 3 on 13th, 20th, and 27th July. Afternoon. The first workshop is for you to find out whether there's any foreign DNA in your food sample using PCR. So you will do PCR to find out whether there's foreign DNA in your food sample. Okay, second workshop is on genetically modified organism. You are using PCR as well to analyze whether the food sold in Singapore are genetically modified or not. This one is a 2 session, you must attend both. Okay, now listen. Please take into consideration that you have to study for your common, for your prelim 1. Okay? Don't sign up already then to say I need to study, I cannot attend. Okay? Hey, no, this was this July, oh, sorry. Wiley commitment. Are you involved? No. CCA commitment or whatever commitment you have. Okay. Now, what I am emphasizing here, what I'm really emphasizing here is that, okay, you must attend if you sign up. I think it might clash with your prelim schedule. You still have assessment on 8 July? Maybe some of you know. Not. Okay. Okay, when is the deadline for sign up? The deadline for sign up is 10 June. You only have a few days to decide whether you want to go for this workshop or not. Any other questions about this workshop? The rest, please just go to your website and read the details. Okay, we'll end here today. Thank you.